Okay, now I have some footage imported into an event that I have created, and I have several clips that have been uploaded to iMovie. And so now once you have your footage imported, you want to create a new project. And you can do this by selecting the plus sign, clicking on the plus sign here in the lower right of the project library panel, or you can go to File and select New Project. You will then have the option of naming the project, and we'll name this project Jekyll Island. You can also select the aspect ratio, either widescreen or standard, and I'm going to select widescreen. You can also select the frame rate, and you should select whatever matches your video source. You can also automatically add a transition to your project. I'm going to leave that unchecked at the moment. And you can select a project theme, and I'm going to select no theme. So we'll create a new project. And so now you see that a new window has opened up here, which is your project timeline. And this is where you are going to drag and drop your footage to build your video. Now we can begin adding media to build a video project. And I think I'll start with this clip right here. You can see that this clip is 8.8 seconds in duration, and we can preview it by placing the playhead, this is the red vertical line, at the beginning of that clip and hitting the spacebar on our computer keypad. And you can see that it plays in the viewer window. If we want to add the entire clip, we can double click it and hit the return key, and this selects the entire clip. Then all we have to do is just drag it and drop it into our project timeline. And you can see there is a green vertical bar showing where this clip can be added. And we release it, and now it's in our timeline. Let's add some more clips. I can add only a portion of a clip by clicking once on the clip and then dragging the ends of the frame, the yellow frame, to encompass the portion that I wish to add. And so now we'll drag this one and drop it into the timeline. Notice that all of the video that has been added, there is now an orange line underlining that portion that has been added to your project, so you can keep track of what you've added. So let's continue adding some footage this way until we have all of the video clips in the sequence we wish to have them. In the next part, we'll look at how to rearrange and modify clips.